Hey YouTube, my name is Jeff, and this episode will be a little different than my usual videos. Today we will be unboxing the new Raspberry Pi Model B+, and the Pimaroni PiGlow. I purchased these electronics for a little project that I will be working on called RetroPie. I am designing a case for this project in my CAD system, and will be 3D printing it as well. The case will feature an open top design to allow the PiGlow's LEDs to illuminate the area around it when the Pi is in use. Now, on to the products themselves. First, let's open up the Raspberry Pi Model B+. This is the Model B+. It is very similar to the Model B in specs, but it has some great improvements over its predecessor. First, it has an extended 40-pin over the original 26 GPIO header for even more connections to your Raspberry Pi. And while it has been extended, the first 26 from the original Model B are in the exact same place, so all your projects should be compatible with the Model B+. Second, in place of the original two USB ports on the Model B, the B+ has four full-size USB ports on the side to allow for even more connectivity. Third, they have replaced the original SD card slot with a smaller, easier-to-use micro SD card slot that stays out of the way. They also removed the previous composite video port and replaced it with a 4-pole 3.5mm headphone jack. Finally, the Model B+ has a better power supply, four rectangular layout mounting holes rather than the original three, a new USB and Ethernet controller chip, and also reorganized connectors on the board to be more efficient. I love this new Raspberry Pi, and I'm excited to start using it for my RetroPie project soon. Now that we have the Model B+ all unboxed, let's open up the PiGlow by Pimaroni. This little board is a great little add-on to get visual feedback from the Raspberry Pi. The PiGlow has 18 total LEDs, with three of each of the six colors, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and white. I plan to use the PiGlow with the RetroPie setup and program it to change the color scheme of the LEDs to fit the console I selected to emulate. The PiGlow is pretty easy to connect to your Raspberry Pi, and it connects through the GPIO headers on the board without any soldering. I plan on assembling the RetroPie console as soon as I get the case finalized, and then I'll be 3D printing it to house the Pi and the PiGlow. I hope you enjoyed this video, and be sure to stay tuned for my RetroPie mini-series in the coming week. Thanks again for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more awesome 3D modeling and printing videos.